have seen people asking, what is it about IIT that makes it so much different? Is it the students? Is it the teachers? Is it the placements? Or all of it is just a hype? So different IITs have different cultures, different traditions, and an amazing charm of its own. So the number of girls that study in IIT are way less than the number of boys. So I thought, why not make a video having the perspective of girls who have studied in IIT themselves and get a holistic view of life at IIT. So presenting to you some fun, crazy, and inspiring answers from these girls, which will help you decide why IIT is different.
Hi, I'm Trishla. I'm from IIT Bombay.
Hey guys, I'm Mugdha, Y15 IIT Kanpur, Electrical Engineering. I graduated in 2019. I have been working as an associate at Boston Consulting Group.
Hi guys, my name is Devanjana Kaur and I'm a master's student from IIT Kharagpur from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. I'm currently a senior research fellow there as well.
Hi, my name is Itisha. I was a mathematics and computing master's student at IIT Guwahati and currently I'm working as an analytic consultant.
Hello, I'm Siddhi. I'm a fourth year dual degree student at IIT Bombay. I'm currently the Institute Girls nominee and I'll be soon joining Procter & Gamble as supply chain manager.
Hi guys, this is Isha Gupta. For a living, I try to solve cool business problems using statistics, machine learning and AI. And I just graduated from Columbia University, completing my master's degree in business analytics. Prior to that, I worked in India for 2 years after completing my BTech from IIT Roorkee in 2017.
Which specific tradition of your IIT do you fancy the most?
Has to be that of the unique Diwali celebration that we have at Kharagpur. It's called Illumination or Illu, as we KGPNs call it. It's absolutely unique to IIT Kharagpur. And it's a green Diwali celebration that we have. We do not burst crackers, but rather we decorate the entire campus. We have one of the largest campuses among all the IITs. We decorate the entire campus with around 2 lakh earthen lamps or diyas.
There's this tradition wherein the freshers are taught Mafia. And Mafia is a game basically which you play in a group, and that's the game which continues for 4 or 5 years until people, you know, graduate. So that is one thing about IIT Bombay, you'll find people playing Mafia every time.
I'm not sure if it's a tradition, but let's assume it is. So the tradition of making excursions to Rishikesh is, I think, I fancy the most. The reason is that I think Rishikesh is a place that teaches you both the extremities of life. On one hand, being a really holy place, it introduces you to spirituality and a sense of calmness and peace. And on the other hand, it introduces you to the adventures and thrill of life through river water rafting and bungee jumping. And experiencing all that with your strongest bonds in college is, I think, really phenomenal. I believe that every person from IIT Roorkee must be having some other special memories associated with the Rishikesh.
Any incident from your hostel or campus life that you can recall from the tagline, what happens in IIT stays in IIT?
It's what happens in IIT stays in IIT. I'm not supposed to say it outside.
In our fourth year in our hall, we had this small balcony kind of thing in front of 2 rooms. That was the party adda of the entire wing. I honestly cannot imagine a time when there was nobody having fun there or there was nobody chilling there. And trust me, I'm not kidding when I say it's also the daytime, nighttime obviously. So cannot even be telling you what kind of parties we had there. So yes, what happened in that balcony stays in that balcony.
I'll tell you about a tradition which happens in IIT Bombay. I'm not sure if it happens in any other IIT or not, but it's called Valfi. And all the passing out or graduating students have sort of a valedictory function in their hostels overnight, where they call all of their friends to roast them. And it is like really, really very embarrassing, but it's so much fun.
Yes, there are a lot of events that are coming to my mind. But again, what happens in IIT stays in IIT. Okay, just to give you a little bit about it, there are a lot of events like, you know, sneaking into hostels or places where you aren't allowed, or going onto terraces where, of course, you aren't allowed again. So such events keep on happening, but there are a lot of other incidents as well which aren't appropriate to say here.
Transformations you experience by being in IIT.
Yeah, there are lots and lots of transformations that I've seen after going to IIT, both in terms of academics and in terms of my personal life. So, in terms of academic, I started understanding the things way better than I used to because of the amazing teachers that you get at IIT. And in terms of personal life, my way of looking at things have changed because after having met a lot of people in the campus, coming from different parts of the country, having different culture, different mindset, and different way of looking at things, I have started analyzing the things way better and enhance my perspective towards various things.
I used to be an introverted person till 12th standard, did not talk to a lot of people, did not initiate conversations at all, minded my own business mostly. Changed that entirely on campus. I won't say it came easily, I did put in efforts for that, but Kanpur gave a beautiful environment to support that.
There are definitely a lot of transformations that I saw in myself. I started playing basketball better. I never thought I could act or sing or dance, and I did all the three of them. So IIT Bombay gives a lot of opportunities, and it's not just in number but also the scale at which all of these things happen. I also think that I've become a great multitasker. There was a time when I could handle academics with a position of responsibility and being in a tech team. So all of these things put together, you're just constantly pushed by the people around you, and I think that's the best part. You learn a lot about ownership, doing the things that you've undertaken to a really good extent.
Both personal and professional transformations, I have to say, because professionally, definitely, like, I got to own my skills a lot, and they're not just from classroom, because classroom education, yes, they are great, everything is fine, but what really helped me was, you know, being part of these amazing projects that you get to do, and being part of these projects are, you learn a lot, you get to own your skills to a great level.
Views on IIT's boys.
What views?
At the end of the day, they are still boys. The adjective IIT doesn't make a difference. They are just like boys we find outside IIT of all sorts. Let me share a very fun incident. So, we all know that in IIT or in a lot of engineering colleges, there is a rule that during placements and internships that once you get an offer and once you accept it, you cannot sit in the companies coming afterwards. So once what happened during our internship search, I got an offer from a startup and I wanted to sit for this company which was coming afterwards. It was like a big core company. So I rejected that offer. It was kind of a risky decision, and I mean, I just wanted to sit for that company. It doesn't guarantee that you get an internship, but I still just went for it. Now meanwhile, one of guys from my friends group accepted the offer from the same startup. And I don't know if it's male ego or what, next day, he and his friend made a fun comment on me. They said, hey, so you rejected the offer, but have you decided which person you'll send in instead of you in that big core company's interview, because you know how dumb you are, right? So, I don't know, it just made me push like really hard, and I think like motivated me to my gut. Fast forward to 4 weeks, I got luckily internship in the same company, and fast forward to 4 years, the same guy calls me up and says, hey, can you share your resume with me, and can you share the tips and guidelines on how should I prepare for internship interviews, and what resources did you use, and anything that you can tell me. Only takeaway is that don't let it affect you. Take your critics seriously, only to push you to push yourself harder and not bring you down.
They're nice. I mean, there is generally a rumor going around saying that general IIT guys are desperate, but I think that's wrong. They are not. They are really good friends of, I mean, yeah, I've been in IIT, I've met a lot of guys from IIT, and they are not desperate at all. They are nice people, they respect women a lot. They might have some conservative views, but they'll never disrespect any woman. I mean, I've rarely faced that in IIT.
I have a very broad question. I cannot give a generic answer. It's not even fair to generalize. You'll find all sorts of boys on campus. People you'd want to hang out with, people you'd not want to hang out with, people who see you so much more than just being a girl, but also boys who cannot see anything further than you just being a girl. I have very, very good friends I've made on campus. But again, I've also come across people, so I'll narrate one incident. There was this freshers tournament. I was playing a table tennis match. It was me versus a boy. And all the cheering that went around was, "Are ladki se harega kya?" So yeah, it was not about him winning or losing. It was about him winning or losing from a girl. So that does happen. But I cannot generalize. I've had very good experiences as well.
Like any other college, I've met all sorts of boys in the campus. There were a few with whom I was very comfortable with, and there were a few with whom the situation was quite opposite. So if I talk about the characteristics of IIT boys, which makes them stand apart, is that they are sharp and they give you a sense of competitiveness in the classroom when you sit with them. So if I quote an incident, I've got a comment from one of my classmates on my clothing, which I did not expected after going to such a good institution like IIT. But yeah, the number of boys like that is very, very less in the campus. Most of the boys that you will encounter in the campus will respect you being a girl.
It is believed that girls refrain from branding themselves as compared to their male counterparts. Do you agree with that?
I do agree with that. So like, I keep telling myself that I should brand myself. I generally, like, girls try to be perfectionists, so even if they are a little less away from perfection, they think they are not good enough, and that happens to all of them. Like, I've spoken to a lot of girls, not just in IIT, outside as well, and that's, I think, is a big issue with girls. They don't brand themselves, so people think they are not the best at what they do, but they are. So I think girls should start branding themselves and be more confident.
Definitely, I agree with the fact that girls are afraid from branding themselves as compared to their male counterparts. What is the reason for that? Just think about the characteristics of most popular guys and most popular girls in college. Now, what are the characteristics of most popular guys? They are usually all-rounder, they are great at networking, they are usually part of so many activities. They're usually basically really popular, right? What are the characteristics of popular girls? They are slim, they are fair, they are beautiful, they are great with conversations with boys. So basically, I think I'm not questioning the natural way of world getting attracted to men and women. I'm sharing this because I think we let it affect us so much subconsciously that our goals become really small. And I think inherently we girls try to seek validation from outside. We seek appreciation from outside, and if we don't, or we just experience any sort of criticism, we just leave it. And I think we can be rather a little more fearless and bold in terms of exploring our own strengths, working towards them, brushing them up, and creating brand out of it.
I think this calls for a 2-3-fold answer. So the first part to this answer would be that number of women in the technical domain is quite skewed. So the number of male brands you'll see emerging will definitely be way more than the number of female brands you'll see emerging. Secondly, there was this interesting study by Google. So this study was in the software domain, that the number of people who actually start off in this career is quite high. But as the years go on, or as you see the age groups, the number dwindles. Because what happens is women, they get married, they have kids, they get more involved in looking after a family, and in this process a lot of them actually leave their jobs to look after their family. Now I think in this case women have to learn to...
Have you ever been in a situation where you were favored for being a girl at IIT? Me personally, no, but I've definitely seen such cases or circumstances. Sometimes you do need a girl's perspective or a girl's opinion, which is why the need for a girl arises inevitably.
As whether a girl or not, I don't know, but for being an IITian, I think the biggest favor that we get is during our placements. The starting package that we get is way more than what a non-IITian would get for the same position at the same organization.
Yes, all of us have been. It's not that uncommon. The one that I can probably remember off the top of my head is becoming a secretary for a programming club at the end of my first year. Nobody told me it was because I was a girl, but I knew that. There were 10 of us. I was the only girl. The other 9 were very good. I knew no programming. I did not pursue that. Sorry to the coordinators. But yes, it does happen. It's a pretty controversial topic.
I did not find any such incident where I was being favored for being a girl at IIT. However, there was one incident where everyone was saying that you will be favored for being a girl, but I did not take it as a favor. So let me quote that incident. We have a student senate council in IIT Guwahati, and there is this post of PG senator, and there were like 6-7 seats for that. So only 2 girls were there who were applying for this post, me and my friend, and apart from that 10 to 12 boys were there who were applying for the same post. So whenever I went for campaigning, everyone was like, yeah, tum to ladki ho, tum to jeet hi jaoge, tumhe votes mangne ki kya zarurat hai. But I did not take it as a favor. Ultimately won the elections.
Okay, I'll give you an example. I told you about how I was very nervous, conscious when I had to go for the NSO trials. So what happened there was, yeah, there were a lot of guys and they know how to play basketball pretty well. I didn't know how to play at all. So, but still I was selected, and a lot of the guys were jealous because like they actually played basketball before. They were really good at it, but we had like so many seats. And girls team needed a lot of new players, so that's why I was selected.
One word or one phrase for your college life?
It was enough for a lifetime, but a lifetime wasn't enough for it. Sorry for sliding my stupid philosophy into this.
Enriching and memorable.
I would say best life ever I could ever imagine.
One of the most amazing phase of my life.
Infi lit. I would say. What would be your suggestions or message for the other girls out there?
To be more aware of their surroundings and of the opportunities that are there, because nowadays there are lots of avenues and lots of opportunities, streams that you probably never have heard before, and like really interesting career options are there. Keep an eye out for all these things.
I would want to say that the 2 years of dedication and hard work which I put in my plus two are totally, you know, paid off, because there is so much that this place offers, and I really feel so happy and lucky to be here, because it's probably the best place to be in.
I would say apply to IIT, give the exam. I mean, it's not that girls are not intelligent, that's why they are not able to get in. It's that only a few number of girls apply. So like if you see the ratio of people who apply and get in, it's the same for guys and girls. So girls, you are actually as intelligent as the guys. So don't keep being a girl as a restraint for yourself, and apply to IIT and become an engineer and just break all the stereotypes.
Don't try to find yourselves in the definitions of the world. Each of us is unique, and just do whatever you feel like having fun in and you feel comfortable doing, and just explore a lot. Do so many things in IIT. I still believe that I should have done that. I left that. I should have met more people. And I think I would have, like, if I get a chance to go back to IIT, I think I would network a lot.